Tony Parker, professional, hungry, leads in his own Tony Parker way to be the best that he can be.
He held his own and quickly earned the respect he deserved.
And he became a man and a leader and an MVP, all-star, so remarkable story.
He just, you know, developing that Hall of Fame player that we have today.
For a young Frenchman, he was great. He was a remarkable player.
Tony made himself into a great player. Tony, you know, typical Spur.
I've played against Tony for years. Years and years and years and years. He's responsible for me not winning more championships.
Man, Tony was just tough to guard, man.
Parker again, the layup drill has started.
Obviously his speed was almost second to none, speed with the basketball.
Oh yeah, his speed was incredible.
Tony scored!
That floater, him scoring in the paint, was legendary.
In the paint, oh, pick up your shot!
Tony wasn't asked to be Tony when he that first year or second year, like early on. Tony was a different player. It wasn't the Tony of later on where he evolved into one of the top point guards and scoring point guards that he was.
Pass to Parker. He blazes down the left side. Peyton extends on it. Parker drives by him into the lane and reverse up and in.
Tony was tough though. He didn't get the credit for being as tough as he was. Never backed down from anybody. I mean, he was up for any challenge.
Rebound Duncan. Here comes Parker up tempo. Tony in the front court, driving on Harris, spinning all the way in, lay it up and good. A little French kiss off the glass for Tony Parker.
He competed extremely hard. He was a scrappy defender. He always found ways to make big shots.
Miller picks up Parker on the screen. Now Bosch has him. Parker on the drive, nearly lost it, still dribbling. Parker with two to shoot. Just gets it off in time, and he banks it in! What a shot from Parker!
He was just a big-time performer, man.
It's to Tony Parker. Parker rises up and hits the shot! Tony Parker at the buzzer!
And a great competitor.
Tony Parker! Ginobili for the win! No! Walker! Parker, one more shot!
That's good!
Oh!
With the 28th pick in the 2001 draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Tony Parker of Racing Club Paris, France.
I had no idea when I first came, no idea where San Antonio was on the map, the way I was welcomed and the way they treated me like their son, because I was so young when I arrived. I was excited, and I was excited about the opportunity, and I knew I was ready. In my head, I was dreamt about this, worked hard for this, and I just had to just be myself and play my game.
Oh, here comes the newcomer, 19 years old from France, Tony Parker. Parker's the youngest player to ever wear a Spurs uniform.
All right, I'm here with Tony Parker. Now, first of all, you're 19. We need to talk about that, because that's younger than my little brother. How is that, being in the NBA at 19?
I don't know. I'm very happy to be here, and I know I'm young, but I think I can play, and I'm gonna learn a lot.
I knew he was gonna be a good one and all that, but I know he was really young, and it was kind of a feeling out process where you just gotta get used to people.
I knew he was a great player, but he never talked to me, you know, during my first year.
I don't think I said 10 words to him the entire first year, not for any other reason than I don't know what to talk about with the kid, so. Okay, that's exaggerated, because I know at some point in the first year I had to talk to him. First impressions, skinny little kid. Freaking, how old was he? Like 12 when you showed up here. Spoke very bad English, still does. And having him call plays and trying to figure out what he's trying to say, I remember that part early on. I know that didn't talk to him the first year. I don't know if he had much to talk about. Again, I remember like whatever it was, second or third game into the season, all of a sudden he's tossed a starting job. And it's like, oh wow, I gotta go play with a 12-year-old against these pros.
When Tony was 19, when he was a rookie, I remember talking to him, and I thought, gosh, he's from France. It's got to be hard on him. And I said, you know, how do you deal with Pop yelling at you? And he goes, I love when Pop yells at me. And I just thought that was the best answer. Because he was a coach's kid, you know, he was a coach's son. You know, his dad was a really good player. And so he got it, he understood it, you know, like, and that's, I think, what made Tony great.
I think Tony got it worse than me.
Really?
I had a few tough months, especially my second year. Tony had it for a little longer because of his position and what Pop demanded from the point guard. There were some tough video sessions. Some very tough, like, after the video session, just, you know, give him a hug, saying, stay with it, you're fine. But yeah, he was rough for a few years, actually.
I remember a lot of stories, you know, a lot of times when Pop was really tough on Tony, and Tony just kept charging back, you know, kept getting up and doing what Tony did. I feel like Pop has a lot to do with, for, you know, who Tony is. I doubt that would be the case if Pop would not be tough on Tony.
And he understood why he was being yelled at and what everybody else was watching him react, how they were watching him react, and why it was important as the point guard especially to not take that personally. And he got it. At a very young age he got it, you know? And so, and he became as good as any point guard in his era, you know, was a key part of those teams.
Yeah, it was hard to play for him at the beginning because I thought he was never happy. At the same time, you know, it made me tougher because he knew that and the way I was and the way I was thinking, like, he knew I was never going to give up. And so that's why I think he pushed so hard.
Now, Tony was special, and what he went through, I mean, having to deal with Pop at that role, point guard position at 19 or 18, my God, he took it.
At the end of the day, for me, I wanted to win, and I know it was coming from a place that he was very competitive, and he really wanted to win too. And so that's what I respected. You know, I wanted to win too. I wanted to be the best point guard in the NBA, and so we pushed each other.
Welcome back to Quest Wolves Live. The Spurs have relied heavily on Tony Parker so far this year. They may not be as deep, and without Ginobili, they certainly don't have the depth of scoring in their starting lineup. But Tony Parker's a guy who can almost beat you single-handedly.
Manu was not playing that game, so Pop was calling my number a lot. Just one of those games that, like, starts well and feeling good, shots going in. I was just being very, very aggressive.
Parker again. Oh my! He comes up and slips it with a right scoop. Comes off that pick. Got it again! Tony Parker steps up with another deuce this time.
Parker again. So smooth, so easy. 10 of 17 tonight.
And hits the jumper. Tony Parker tearing him up tonight. Parker got the basket, and Tony Parker has just matched his career high.
Tony Parker scoring at will tonight.
Got it again! Spurs back on top to Parker. For the tie.
That's good.
Got it! Tony Parker with a deuce! Oh, mama! How about that?
You could tell as soon as it left his hands. Just a terrific shot by Tony Parker. He's unconscious right now.
Tony Parker has been ridiculous all night long.
Everything was falling in, and so you just feel it, you know, when it's a good night. When you're in that zone, you know, you feel like everything is going to go in. And I just kept going and ended up with 55.
Man. Parker, Tony Parker, 40 points tonight.
He has been simply unstoppable in the midst of a career night.
Tony, what are you, nuts? Wow. Can't you read the stat sheet?
Parker hits. Best scoring night of Tony Parker's career. Player of the game. You see his numbers. Remarkable. Tony Parker, 55 points tonight, shattering the opponent individual record against the Timberwolves all time.
It's still the record. It's still the record for a European player, so we'll see. I guess Antetokounmpo had 53 last year, so it was pretty close. But records are, I'm sure somebody will beat it.
You want entertainment?
Grundy, let me ask you the same question I asked Will. You got as much talent as Tony Parker and myself. Yeah. We still have to do all this stuff.
Yeah. We got a game tomorrow, so you guys are going to lighten up on the press a little bit, right? You can't talk to those guys 24 hours a day, Tony. I don't care if they're from Paris or not, right? All they want is a story. You want to win basketball games, so you can spend some time on the game and not all
nice
those people.
Like you, Bob. I'm just trying to be nice with the press.
I always say it's just an incredible advantage that you can, that you play with the same point guard for 15 years, and you know him, you know his strengths, you know when he's in a weaker spot, and when you can help him out, or when he can help you out.
Manu pushed the ball ahead to Parker. Parker all the way in, lay it up, and good. Tony Parker from Manu Ginobili.
Manu puts it on the deck off Pavlovich, met by Varejao. Parker a three. Good. Oh, Tony Parker hit a big three.
As a player, the speed.
Rebound tipped by Finley, grabbed by Alberto. Ahead to Parker, up tempo, attacks all the way in. Tony with the layup in the left hand, he scores.
Grease lightning, can you say about Tony Parker?
Parker's to the basket, banks it in. Tony Parker putting on a show once again.
And I think the speed and also his ability to get to the rim, get hit, and still finish plays.
Beautiful scoop play by Tony Parker from way down low.
Parker back to way beyond the three-point arc now. Parker on the drive. Parker to the basket. He scores, count it, and he's fouled.
I don't know that I've ever seen a player that gets knocked down as much as Tony did, and he got up every time.
Here's Parker. So quick down the... Oh, what a shot from Parker! Lightning fast, and then a circus shot as he falls down.
Tony Parker again, going one on three, taking Pavlovich into the paint, abusing him.
The tenacity and the resilience that this little French guy showed across his career, and also, you know, the respect that he earned across the world in basketball, not only in the NBA, but throughout the European game, and what he did for French basketball. Doesn't happen without a real strong personal fortitude.
They stay on their feet and cheer in San Antonio as Parker and Duncan pick apart the Cavaliers.
If Spurs win it all, do you think you will be the finals MVP?
It's a long way, man. It's a long way, but I don't think about that. You know, I'm just trying to be aggressive and just try to play my game. And whatever happens, still going to be Timmy the man, you know? Timmy is our star in our team.
A Parker three. Good! Tony doing it all!
Duncan has it down low, back to Parker. 22-footer right wing. Good!
I think the finals MVP felt good, you know, for him, because the finals are the biggest, you know, that was, it's the measuring stick of the NBA. Regular season's important, but the NBA playoffs and finals, and I think that finals MVP for him. And obviously, it felt good for me, but really good for him, because he had worked so hard.
It's a very, very long journey, but it's all worth it. When you hear that buzzer and you, the last team standing, it's just a great feeling.
And for the third time in 5 years, and the fourth time in their rich history, the San Antonio Spurs are NBA World Champions.
San Antonio Spurs win the World Championship.
To be there and get that trophy, you know, it's an unbelievable feeling.
To the MVP of the 2007 NBA Finals, Tony Parker, we say congratulations and bonne chance.
That's three.
Three's not easy.
In 5 years, it's tough.
Everybody, put your hands together for Tony Parker.
Man, I'm so happy. I want to thank everybody is here to support us. I always say you're the best fan in the NBA, and it was a great, great journey.
To play with a great team, and it's our third championship in 5 years for me, four for the city of San Antonio, and hopefully we'll do it again next year. Thank you.
For people who never got to sit at courtside, I brought the Canadian ambassador to a game one night, and we sat at courtside. You don't realize how fast and quick he is until you see him up close on the court. I mean, he is flying every minute that he's there, and he's looking around and he's making decisions and he's not being shy and he's not hesitating. Talk about a guy who ran the floor and ran the team. For a young Frenchman, he was great.
And when you don't trap him, you got to try to force him to shoot jump shots, because once he breaks down your defense and get in the paint, it's over. And then he became a better short passer, interior passer in the lane, and that continued to help his game take that next step.
For a point guard, you know, Tony was, you know, normal for point guards at that time in the league, you know, but he always was very lean, carried a light frame, but he was so quick and able to penetrate and get into the paint, and he had his classic teardrop that was so effective for him, but, you know, all the spin moves that Tony would make, and he was certainly a guy that had high efficiency around the basket, was a great finisher. You know, that just was his style of play.
Teardrop was a great shot for me because I had to find a way to score and to shoot over the bigs, and so I've been doing that shot since I was a kid, and so when I arrived in San Antonio, it was a great shot for me, and now when I see all the NBA guys using it, it's pretty cool. You had the finger roll, you know, with Iceman, and you got the teardrop with me.
You know, I'm so happy, and the rings is the most important. But as a player, you always want to get the recognition, and that's why I think Pop never worried about me about trying to get better, because I wanna be named one of the best point guard in the league, and so to be named like that, you have to go to the All-Star team.
It's a great opportunity to enjoy everybody and see all the stars. You know, me, I'm from France, you know, so every time I go to the All-Star, I can see Magic and Michael Jordan, and I'm still a huge fan of the game, and I like meeting everybody, and it's fun, and especially being voted by the coaches, it means a lot. I don't have a favorite, because I think each championship is special. But the fourth one, the way we did it and the basketball that we played was unbelievable.
Parker gets in the paint, layup, rolls around and drops in. As good as anybody in the NBA. Duncan hands to Ginobili. Inside Duncan, out to Parker for three. Bang!
And so that's why I really appreciate everything in 2014, because I felt like maybe it was going to be our last championship, and then I was right, it was our last one.
The San Antonio Spurs are the world champions.
I mean, Tony's such a special player, such a unique point guard, such a great leader, so much experience, so much success. He was always such an impressive guy, a guy that stood out from early on and continued to stand out throughout his career.
He was my anchor. He was the guy that knew who I was and what I could do. So for me, Tony was very important.
It was special to see him come in and how he came in. He didn't come in from America's system. He came in from a European system.
You talk about an individual who was so focused and understanding of what they wanted in this life, as far as he wanted to be a champion. And you saw it from day one. There was nothing that ever took precedence over what he was doing on the floor.
Tony developed as a leader. He didn't come in as a leader with a voice, but through Pop's prodding, through the strength of the organization, he found his voice. And it was probably one of the most impressive parts of his development, is how he grew as a leader.
I think that leadership, you know, really kind of guided him to where he knew he could play, and it took him to another level.
He was a sort of thoughtful leader. You know, I think that his leadership abilities sort of mirrored his talent. He was such a great player.
It's one of the hardest things to do, is self-improvement. And he looked in the mirror and said, I'm going to get better at this, and put it out there. And that's what impressed me, is some people will keep that a secret, because if they fail, then no one knows. Tony put that edict out there. I'm going to get better. I'm going to be a better shooter. I'm going to be a more complete player. Not only did he put it out there, he succeeded in grand fashion.
That might be the most remarkable thing about Tony. I mean, his maturity level was off the charts. He understood everything that we said to him. He was able to handle criticism, because I was very tough on it. And he just took it all in and got better and better, got tougher and tougher. At that young age, he was pretty remarkable.
So many people that you were associated with in the Spurs organization have been in the Hall of Fame in the last few years. What does that mean to you?
It's kind of crazy, you know, because I've been the last 2 years for Timmy and then for Manu. And then this year, going with Coach Pop, it's pretty cool to go to go with your coach.
I feel like I'm lucky, kind of, because I'm like excited about the new life, because obviously I love basketball and I accomplished everything that I wanted to accomplish. And if I play basketball, it's to win a championship. And so that's why I'm happy that I took the time when I was playing to create all those opportunities. And like that, it was easy for me to walk away.
When I was at Tony's jersey retirement, you know, it just was amazing, like, to see all that had happened. Like, you know, he had, you know, won these championships and really changed French basketball, changed the, you know, there had never really been an international point guard like that. He was also probably one of the youngest players in the backcourt that had, you know, come into the NBA that early. It was like a surreal moment to see that happen.
The mentality, everything. I think we had something that it was very special between the big three, Pop. We didn't take it for granted. It's very special. The bond that we created, and I think it's going to be very hard to duplicate that for 20 years with no ego and all that winning for 20 years.
Coach Pop, for me, the impact that you had in my life, and I had an unbelievable dad, but you were an unbelievable second dad to me. You taught me a lot, and I'll be thankful forever. Thank you very much, Papo.
You know, it was one of the more rewarding things that I've done in sports, because when you're with someone that long, when you see them grow as people and go through the ups and downs with you, because you've gone through those trials and tribulations together, and it means a lot over time.
Before I go, I want to do one thing with the Spurs fan all together. Can I ask for a last favor before I go? I want a big Go Spurs Go on three. Can we do it one more last time for me? One more last time all together. One, two, three.